Let's talk about I'm splitting his top body in three parts. Right, high mount, middle or low, okay? We wanna work in the middle right now, okay? When I will make sure his elbow is not into my legs, right, between my legs and his body, okay? I will start to set up a simple attack like Americana, okay? I will have both ribs like that, my thumb will be together, and I will control his wrist with 2-1-1 here, okay? I will roll to open his arm a little bit and make his palm of hands kind of face to my body, okay? So as soon as I'm here, with my toes on the ground, will help with my mobility. I will start to drive his arm to the ground, not just pushing with my arms, but driving my body weight together. In a way, I will be more strong than him. Doesn't matter the size, okay? So with my elbow now will be connecting below his ear, okay? And I wanna make sure it's my opponent here who will never drive the head inside of my arms here on that hole, on that gap. Okay, so I'm holding tight here, and I will also make sure I will put his arm on 90 degrees. And with that grip and that elbow very tight, it will be also really hard to the person to extend the arm away. Okay, so from here, that will be my outside hands here. We'll come on that way, underneath his arm, okay, underneath his arm. Sometimes this person is too strong and they try to keep down on the ground. I can palm up sometimes, facing to my body, and I kind of using my fingers to dig, to have my arm inside, then I palm down again and control my wrist, my own wrist, okay? Let's say, and imagine we have what we can call a line, a shoulder line here, okay? And we know about his body, every time his elbow is above the shoulder line, he will be more flexible to resist my position, okay? So my goal is always keep his elbow below that shoulder line, when he will never be so flexible, and I can easy get in the point, he will feel straight on the joint, and he will tap, okay? So it's my goal here. As soon as I get here, and I get this control of my own wrist, I will kind of slide the back of his hand on the mat, like I'm broom to cleaning the mat with his hands. I will keep his hands and wrist on the ground, but his elbow, I will use my leverage, I create here with my arms, to lift him up, so this goes straight on his shoulders, okay? Also, as soon as we know we gotta bring this elbow below the line, sometimes you feel like you have no room, you're gonna be stuck on your own knee. So bring your knee a little bit backward, so we have more room to slide this down and lift this elbow off the ground, I kind of cleaning the mat with the back of his hands, and I can have a good and safe submission here. Okay, we call Americano. On this process, sometimes we start with some position, and we know he's probably gonna try to defend, and every time he avoid my position, we gotta pay attention in the next step or which opportunity I can take from that, okay? So on this position here, when I get here, many times on that transition, I post my elbow. When I release my second hand to come underneath, he will not be able to stand the arm on that angle, but a lot of times he can try to straight up, right? So if I feel that coming, when I start to release, he starts to straight up, I will follow him with my body and keep walking to try to hit my wrist. I will make sure my forearm will be underneath the elbow like a table so I can create that pressure on his joint. Okay, so when he stretch, I will follow him with my body, tie it up and make sure I spread my heels stay connected, so don't disengage. And I have my body head on top to control his arm. It's my idea here is isolate the arm from the body and create a scenario here when it's my whole body fight against his one arm, I will be more strong. So when I get here, some details important to apply is the first one. Every time you try to hit your own wrist, you're probably gonna have your wrist on that position, on that angle, where it's not good for tapping. I wanna rotate again and bring my wrist up. Create some little leverage here on that turning to create a pressure on his arms. It's my second detail here, really important, is bring my outside elbow a little bit off the ground. So I create that angle to tap him. If he stumps, facing up like that, to the roof, to the sky, I can tap in a straight arm bar. If he try to turn down, I will stop in here, never bend too much, just a little bit is enough. This one is pushing down, turn my wrist, elbow off the ground, is a good angle to tap in here, okay? Thank you very much.